Hey everybody, this is my second video on working with trigonometric identities. In this video, we're going to derive the sum and difference formulas and the double angle identities that follow from these. We'll also use these to simplify trig expressions and verify some identities following the methodology we outlined in the last video. The primary identities we discussed previously that you should remember include our elementary identities, which reduce all the trig functions back to sine and cosine, our Pythagorean identities, which show the basic circular relationship between sine and cosine, our even-odd identities, which describe symmetry, and our complementary identities, which show how trig functions are related to their cofunctions. This video will focus primarily on what are known as the sum and difference formulas. They're the starting point for a number of other fundamental identities you will be learning soon. These identities will give us a formula for computing the cosine or sine of the sum of two angles or the difference of two angles. As you can see below, trig functions do not distribute across angles. For instance, cosine of 60 plus 30 equals the cosine of 90, which is 0. However, the cosine of 60 plus the cosine of 30 is 1 plus the square root of 3 over 2. So the cosine of 60 plus 30 is not equal to the cosine of 60 plus the cosine of 30. The actual formulas are shown here. We usually condense the four equations into the two shown below in red. These were originally derived by Hipparchus of Nicaea back around 150 BC. Hipparchus was an amazing astronomer who, among other things, compiled one of the first trig tables. He determined the approximate distance to and size of the sun and the moon and created a catalog of over 850 stars. We'll start by proving the formula for the cosine of alpha minus beta. We can derive the other three formulas quite easily from this one. Consider an angle alpha which corresponds to the point cosine alpha sine alpha on the unit circle, and the angle beta which corresponds to cosine beta sine beta, and find the length of the secant line segment joining these two points. Using our distance formula, we get the length shown here, that L equals the square root of cosine alpha minus cosine beta squared plus sine alpha minus sine beta squared. Now, if we revolve the angle alpha minus beta so that the initial side is on the x-axis, we see the same line segment now connects the point 1, 0 to the point cosine alpha minus beta, sine alpha minus beta. Again, using the distance formula, we get L equals the square root of cosine alpha minus beta minus 1 squared plus sine alpha minus beta minus 0 squared. Squaring both sides and using some basic algebra, we get our result. The cosine of alpha minus beta equals cosine alpha cosine beta plus sine alpha sine beta. Let's consider a simple example using this formula. Here we want to find the exact value of cosine 15 degrees. 15 degrees is not one of our special angles. However, we can express 15 as 45 minus 30, and now it's the difference of two special angles. Using our difference formula, cosine of 15 equals cosine of 45 minus 30, which is cosine of 45 times cosine 30 plus sine 45 sine 30, which is square root of 2 over 2 times square root of 3 over 2 plus square root of 2 over 2 times 1 half, which equals square root of 6 plus square root of 2 over 4. Now that we have a formula for cosine of alpha minus beta, the other three formulas follow quite easily. For example, the cosine of alpha plus beta equals the cosine of alpha minus a minus beta. If we apply our difference formula, we get the cosine of alpha cosine minus beta plus sine alpha sine minus beta. And by our even-odd identities, this just equals cosine alpha cosine beta minus sine alpha sine beta. So the cosine of the sum is the same as the cosine of the difference, except the plus changes to minus. Using our complementary identity, the sine of alpha minus beta equals the cosine of pi over 2 minus alpha minus beta, which equals the cosine of pi over 2 minus alpha plus beta. Using the cosine of the sum, we get cosine of pi over 2 minus alpha cosine beta minus sine of pi over 2 minus alpha times sine of beta, which again, using the complementary identities, converts back to sine alpha cosine beta minus sine beta cosine alpha. And finally, using the same trick of letting sine alpha plus beta equal sine of alpha minus a minus beta, we show that the sine of the sum is the same as the sine of the difference, just swapping minus for plus. So now we have our four basic formulas. Consider this example where we want to simplify the expression sine of pi plus x. We simply use the sine of the sum formula to expand this out to sine pi cosine x plus cosine pi sine x, but sine pi equals 0 and cosine pi equals negative 1, so we're just left with minus sine x. What if we were asked to verify the identity sine of x plus pi over 4 plus sine of x minus pi over 4 equals the square root of 2 times sine x? Starting with the left-hand side, sine of x plus pi over 4 plus sine of x minus pi over 4, we can expand that out as sine of x cosine pi over 4 plus cosine x sine pi over 4 plus sine x cosine pi over 4 minus cosine x sine pi over 4. The cosine x sine pi over 4 terms cancel, and we get 2 times the sine x cosine pi over 4. Now the cosine of pi over 4 is the square root of 2 over 2, which we multiply by 2, canceling the denominator, and we're left with the square root of 2 times sine x. We can also derive a formula for the tangent of alpha minus beta. Since the tangent of alpha minus beta equals sine alpha minus beta divided by cosine alpha minus beta, this expands out to sine alpha cosine beta minus sine beta cosine alpha divided by cosine alpha cosine beta plus sine alpha sine beta. Now if we want to put this all back in terms of tangent, we can multiply the numerator and denominator by 1 over cosine alpha cosine beta. The cosines all cancel, and we're left with tangent alpha minus tangent beta over 1 plus tangent alpha times tangent beta. Using our even-odd identities, we know that tangent of minus beta equals minus tangent beta, so we can compute tangent of alpha plus beta as tangent of alpha minus and minus beta, which again gives us the same formula with the addition and subtractions both reversed. We usually write this in the combined form shown here. We could, of course, use this to simplify expressions like tangent of pi over 4 minus beta. This formula gives us tangent pi over 4 minus tangent beta over 1 plus tangent pi over 4 times tangent beta. Since the tangent of pi over 4 is just 1, this just leaves us with 1 minus tangent beta over 1 plus tangent beta. A bit more practical application for this formula is to find the angle between two 2D lines. If you recall that the tangent of an angle is the opposite over the adjacent, which is also the rise over the run. So the slope of a line is the same as the tangent of the angle it makes with the x-axis. So here we have two lines, y equals 1 half x plus 1 and y equals 6x minus 2, and we want to find the angle between these two lines. If alpha is the angle that y equals 6x minus 2 makes with the x-axis, then the tangent of alpha equals 6. Likewise, if beta is the angle that y equals 1 half x plus 1 makes, then tangent of beta equals 1 half. Now the angle theta between the two lines is just alpha minus beta. By our formula, the tangent of theta equals the tangent of alpha minus beta, which is tangent alpha minus tangent beta over 1 plus tangent alpha tangent beta, but this just equals 6 minus 1 half divided by 1 plus 6 times 1 half, which reduces to 11 eighths. So the tangent of theta equals 11 eighths, which implies that theta is equal to tangent inverse of 11 eighths, which is 53.97 degrees. Here's a nice application of our sum formula, where the cosine and sine have the same period. In this case, we have the square root of 3 times cosine 2x plus sine 2x. If we use a trick and multiply and divide by 2, we can rewrite this as 2 times square root of 3 over 2 cosine 2x plus 1 half sine 2x. But square root of 3 over 2 equals the cosine of pi over 6, and 1 half equals the sine of pi over 6. So we can rewrite this as 2 times cosine pi over 6 cosine 2x plus sine pi over 6 sine 2x, which by our difference formula equals 2 times the cosine of 2x minus pi over 6. Graphically, this says if we add square root of 3 cosine 2x and sine 2x, we get a new cosine wave with the same period and a different amplitude. We can show this is true in general as long as the cosine and sine have the same period. Here we have the general case, a cosine cx plus b sine cx. The magic number we multiply and divide by is the square root of a squared plus b squared. Using this number, we get the coefficients now correspond to a point on the unit circle. This means we can rewrite them as the cosine and sine of some angle theta. Then applying our difference formula, we get square root of a squared plus b squared times cosine of cx minus theta, which is again a single cosine wave. Let's finish up this video by deriving and demonstrating our very important double angle formulas. These are shown here, and they are all quite easy to derive from our sum and difference formulas. For instance, to find the sine of 2 alpha, Just think of this as the sine of alpha plus alpha, which by our sum formula gives us sine alpha cosine alpha plus sine alpha cosine alpha. So it's just 2 times sine alpha cosine alpha. Similarly, the cosine of 2 alpha equals cosine of alpha plus alpha, which is cosine alpha minus sine alpha, which is cosine squared alpha minus sine squared alpha. There's 2 variations on this second formula, because sometimes we want this expressed just in terms of a single function. All we have to do is use our Pythagorean identity to substitute 1 minus cosine squared for sine squared to get 2 cosine squared alpha minus 1, or similarly substitute 1 minus sine squared for cosine squared to get 1 minus 2 sine squared alpha. All 3 versions of this formula are in fact useful. And of course, we could apply the same trick to derive a formula for tangent of 2 phi. We get tangent of 2 phi is equal to tangent of phi plus phi, which is tangent phi plus tangent phi over 1 minus tangent phi times tangent phi. So we get 2 tangent phi over 1 minus tangent squared phi. Suppose we wish to verify the identity sine of 3 beta equals 3 sine beta minus 4 sine cubed beta. Using the same trick that we did before, we can write 3 beta as beta plus 2 beta. Then using our sine angle sum formula to expand this out, we get the sine of beta cosine of 2 beta plus cosine beta sine 2 beta. Now we can substitute using our double angle identities for each of these. Note I'm using 2 cosine squared beta minus 1 for cosine 2 beta so that it will match the last term. This gives us 4 sine beta cosine squared beta minus sine beta. Now substitute 1 minus sine squared for cosine squared, put this all in terms of sine. If we multiply this out and combine like terms, we have our result, 3 sine beta minus 4 sine cubed beta. Here's a problem where we're given a triangle which describes an angle A, and we're asked to find values for trig functions evaluated at 2a. First, we can find the hypotenuse using our Pythagorean theorem. H squared equals 6 squared plus 12 squared, so h equals the square root of 180, which is 6 square roots of 5. This tells us that the sine of A is equal to 6 over 6 square roots of 5, which is 1 over the square root of 5, and the cosine of A is 12 over the 6 square roots of 5, which is 2 over the square root of 5. Now we just use our formulas. The sine of 2A is 2 sine A cosine A. We get 2 times 1 over the square root of 5 times 2 over the square root of 5, which is 4 fifths. Similarly, the cosine of 2A equals cosine squared A minus sine squared A, which is 4 fifths minus 1 fifth, which is 3 fifths. And finally, since the tangent of 2a equals sine 2a over cosine 2a, this equals 4 fifths over 3 fifths, which is 4 thirds. So let's finish with a problem involving inverse trig functions. We want to convert cosine of 2 times the arc sine of x over 5 to an algebraic statement. Keeping in mind that arc sine represents an angle, the trick we used before was to make a substitution like alpha equals arc sine of x over 5. Now what we need to find is the cosine of 2 alpha. If we draw a triangle for alpha, we're essentially back to our last problem. For our triangle, we have sine of alpha equals x over 5, and using our Pythagorean theorem, we get the missing side b is equal to the square root of 25 minus b squared. Hence, the cosine of alpha is the square root of 25 minus x squared over 5. Now the cosine of 2 alpha is cosine squared alpha minus sine squared alpha, and this works out to 25 minus 2x squared over 25. So this should be enough to get you started working with problems involving sum and difference and double angles. I hope you found this video helpful. You can see more of my math videos at www.mathforeveryone.info. Please feel free to leave comments and suggestions, and thanks for watching. Double, double, toil and trouble.